The battery's in place. You see, welded a little tray for the battery out of angle iron. And all we've got left is to hook up the electronics. Cut out a hole in the frame for the ignition key unit to hook up to all the wires and the starter motor. Here's that unit. I made a little plate to fit just over the top, and it holds it in place so it doesn't spin with the ignition when you try to turn it on. So the plate just fits on like so. There we go, and that's going to go up in here. A couple of little tack welds just underneath here to stop it from spinning, and then on the top, the threads tighten down, then the solenoid is going to go just below, and the battery is going to go in there. So we'll hook battery wires to the solenoid, to the ignition key, and all the wires from the motor.
So we've got some almost to the back of this right cylinder here.
Hold on. We've got some thread in place for the solenoid to go on. Like so. Straight below the key. So the electrics are hooked up, as we can see. We have two wires coming out of here, which we believe is the full fuel cutoff underneath the carburetor. We have the earth of the battery hooked down to the frame. Hard to see, but it's basically the other side. There's a bolt like this on the solenoid, and it's hooked up to that. The earth side of the engine, the two wires, there's a wire coming out from inside. Oh yeah, pretty dark. Well, there we go. There's a wire coming out from inside. This one goes down, and it's hooked in the off position between here and that one at the back, which goes down to the earth. Now that's actually still earth in the on position. Can't figure out why. I think it's because even if you take this off, or the connection on the other side is connected to the motor, and the motor being metal comes, the connection's all the way around to the solenoid. Everything being metal, it's constantly earthed. So test run is we're gonna see whether that matters or not. It shouldn't do. If it does, then we'll simply have to disconnect that and let it hang, and only earth it when we want to shut off. Although, if we go look at the other parts of the electrics, the power comes down to this side of the solenoid, then it comes up, and it's between these two, this one and this one, and in the on position, sorry, that one and that one are the start. So in the start position, that kicks that the solenoid, makes the connection inside, starts up. Then in the on position, we have power between this one at the back and this one, oh sorry, this one at the back and this one here, which sends power to the two cables down here. Sorry, sends power to the one grey cable down here. The one grey cable down here. This other one is simply an earth, earthed to the frame there. But power in on position sends power to there, which opens up the something inside here, which pumps fuel, allows fuel through. If we turn it on slowly, we can hear it open. There we go. On off, on off. Yep, on off, on off. So that's that. Pump it with fuel, start up, see if it runs.